Hi, and welcome to Hormone Nurse, the maintenance diet on the HCG. A lot of times people, they love the first 500 calorie part of the diet. It's very set, it's a set regimen. They like the certain foods, they like that diet, and then it's time to get off of it and add calories. And they're like, what? What do I do now? I don't want to go back to the old way I was eating. Look where it got me at the, you know, at the beginning. No, I don't want to go back there. How do I really eat? Help me. So here I am to talk about the maintenance diet. When you're on the drops, you only have to be on the maintenance for 21 days. When you're on the injections, it's for 6 weeks. So when you're used to being on the drops on the 500 calorie diet and the drops or the injections, you ate at a certain amount of food and a certain type of food. And a lot of people, when they get off, they want to keep up that food because they liked it. They enjoyed eating that certain food. And you know what? That's okay. You can continue eating that same food. But you want to add a little bit of fat now. You can add a little bit more proteins because you want to add calories. You can have around 1,200 to 1,800 to maybe even 2,000 calories, depending on if you're starting to work out now or not. I would suggest, like, say this is an example. If you're going to have a half a grapefruit, you normally have a half a grapefruit in the morning, go ahead and add a couple of eggs with it. Add 3 eggs and only eat 1 egg yolk and 2 egg whites with it. For lunch, add a little bit more chicken. If you're used to having chicken in a salad, have a little bit of dressing over it. Get the olive oil-based dressing and only use a table or 2 tablespoons of it. Now, on the maintenance diet, you still cannot have any sugar and no starchy carbs for another 21 days. Yes, another 21 days. It's good for your body to be without starchy carbs and sugars for a while. You will be okay. So, also, you need to weigh every day when you're on the maintenance, because you're going to take your set weight, which is the weight after the 2 days of 500 calorie diet without the drops. You know how you do that? You stop the drops and then you have 500 calorie one day and then you'll have the 500 calorie the next day. Well, that third day, if that's when you stop, that third day is your ideal weight. If you go 3 days with the 500 calorie and no drops, then you take your fourth morning weight. Let me tell you a little bit about this 500 calorie without the drops, because that's the beginning of the maintenance. Some people, they're really regimented. Oh, I'm going to do 2 days, or oh, I'm supposed to do 3 days. But this is what it's all about. It's really to try to get the drops out of your system. So on the second day, all of a sudden you are hungry, you could eat the person sitting beside you, then you need to go ahead and eat more, because that means the drops are out of your system. If you go the third day and you're still feeling really great, and oh, everything's good, and you're not hungry at all, that's good. Then you can go 3 days. So this maintenance diet lasts 21 days if you're on the drops, and 6 weeks if you're on the injections. So if you're on the drops and you went through the 500 calorie and then you and drops and then you went through the maintenance for 21 days, then if you want, you can restart the drops again. One more thing I want to say before I go, because some people, they like to use those drops and the 500 calorie diet for more than 40 days. They're just like, oh, 1 more pound, I got 5 more pounds, I just got a little bit more pounds. But I'm telling you, after the 40 days, they're not going to work. So you have to do the maintenance and get back on them. So for more diets, recipes, and for more just information on the maintenance or even life after maintenance, you can go to see the blogs on hormonenurse.com, or you can find me on Facebook.